Okay, so welcome back to this class. In this class, we're going to look at how to insert hyperlinks within WPS Office Suite. So to start with, you can just specify where you want to insert the document, or you want to insert the hyperlink, assuming I want to insert it at this point. So I can say see more here. And I want everything to be within this here. Okay, so you can select and highlight where you want to insert that document or that text or that piece of command on or that website. Okay, so let's say I want this here once someone clicks it to take him to somewhere. So what do you want to, where do you want to insert? So you can select it and come to insert over here, and you can come to hyperlink or at the top right over here. So you click on all hyperlink, and this is the hyperlink tab where you can add anything. So this is the first one, the default one. You can add existing file or web page. So if you want to add a web page or an existing file, all you need is just to navigate to wherever that file is. Assuming I want to add something like this picture within this document. Okay, so I select it, and then you can see the address, it's been added to my, to this link. So once I click on OK here, you can see the color of the text has changed, which means if you select the command key or you hold the control key in your keyboard on Windows, on Mac is command. Once you click, it's going to open this image for you directly, which means it's been hyperlinked to that particular text. This image had been hyperlinked to that particular text here. Okay, so once someone click on here, it's going to pop up to that. Okay, so if you want to edit, you can just right click and come to edit hyperlink. If you want to insert something else, for example, you don't want to insert a picture, you want to insert a website, you can come over here and say www.epicdigitalacademy.com, for example, and you can just click on OK. And this is going to be, once you see, want to see more, you click on this, it's going to take you to Epic Digital Academy. So if you click on this, hold down the command key, click on this, and everything is going to take you straight to the Epic Digital Academy. Just like so. So you can see it has just taken you over there. And this is the power of the hyperlinking. You can come over here or right click and say edit hyperlink again, and you can insert places in this document. For example, you want to see more, and the more is at the top of the document or within the header or within a particular bookmark that you've created. Let's say I want anyone that clicked that here to go to the top of the document. I can say okay to this, and once someone click this, once he's working, you just click on this, it's going to bring you to the top of the document, just like so. You can see you're now at the top of the document. So this is the power of the hyperlinking. If you want to remove the hyperlink, you just right click and come to remove hyperlink, or you can copy hyperlink or open hyperlink if you want to open it directly, or you can select the hyperlink and do many more things. So you want to remove, you just click on remove, and the text is back to where it was. Okay, so this is the power of hyperlink. You can connect anything, but the key thing to make sure you, when you want to transfer this document to another document or to another computer, make sure that the directory where you have this hyperlink, maybe a document, maybe a PDF file, is in the same directory with this computer, with the same file that we are working on. Okay, if it's on a different file, then it's not going to open it for you directly, because you can hyperlink even a PDF document. So let's try to hyperlink a PDF document. From here, we can say maybe you want to add this my CV. This is a PDF document. You can click on OK, and it's been hyperlinked. So once you hold on the command key and click on this, it's going to open that the PDF document directly that we have. Okay, so it's very, very fantastic and easy to go ahead and look at it. Okay, so this brings us to the end of hyperlinking in WPS Office Suite. In the next class, we're going to look at how to customize and add charts. Okay, how to add charts and customize them in WPS Office Suite. Okay, so until next time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.